Yo, my music breaks down reality, no be fiction. Respect what I fit do in my jurisdiction. You claims your brains they work and you're always decent. Keep your beef to yourself, I'm on a river fishing. Living a healthy life. Unkwasa, I heard that from your flirty wife. This is AJ Nervous, an official king of BA, live on Pulse TV.
I say power to the people. I saw they fight and overquit till we all equal. Suffer every day. Everybody they need though. Right, it's about to die. What's so quick?
It wasn't bad for me as an artist because I'll say I did not really do much when it comes to music, but I did a lot of humanitarian stuff. I did a lot of charity stuff here and there. Because I'm not just a musician who will be climbing stages here and there and not really doing anything else. When I'm not doing music, I love to focus on, giving. I love to give.
Instead of going up, we keep going under. Instead of a fear, we glorify, we honor. God go to judge us for the bad people we honor. See me, I can't be part of something I'm not proud of, so I stick up for my ghetto.
I think it's really growing. We can actually have an industry, only like a rap industry, hip-hop industry. I don't call it rap because rap is what you do. Hip-hop is way of life. Hip-hop is like, it's creating awareness, loving and, letting people know what's going on in your society, try to do things to help people. That is hip-hop. But rap is just what you do. You go to the studio, you rap. Everybody can rap lately. And rap is doing good because we have a couple of rappers doing very good stuff lately, and we're not listening to hip hop back then. Like should I say, 10 years ago, people were not listening to hip hop. It was all hip life, playing high life beat and rapping upon it. But now we hear more trap beats, and these guys are all becoming mainstream artists and stuff. So it should tell you how far we've come as a general, or yes, like a group of people doing that kind of movement. So hip hop is really doing well right now, and I'm happy the way it is and the direction it's taking right now.
Man, open fire on innocent people. How could God's children be so evil? It's time to be honest before we can't wear. We all dying to live. Tomorrow is not a promise. Yes, I can prove it.
Rap without beef would be very whack and empty, because hip-hop started with beef. And then again, you ask yourself, what kind of beef? What type of beef are you engaging yourself in? Or are you having a healthy beef where you just keep it on record, on beef, like on beat, on wax? You are telling me you're better than me, you're a good rapper, and I'm telling you I'm a good rapper. So in order for people to know who is the best, you go to the studio, you put out a record, I go to the studio, I put out a record, just like Nas and Jay-Z did back then. I don't really encourage like Tupac and Biggie type of beef that get people killed. It gets people killed all the time. So that's not the type of beef I would encourage. But if it's on wax and we are going to make money from it, it puts money in your pocket and it puts money in my pocket. But it has to be real though. You have to paint a picture that the public people, people who are purchasing your stuff will begin to think that it's really real. That's what makes them pay attention to you as a rapper. You don't just do a shallow stuff because someone has offended you, so you've gone to the studio and you start insulting their mother and they call it beef. That is not beef, that is stupidity to me.
I have a dream,
Love is here. Painted just around the corner too, over there. Yeah.
All I'm saying is that Musica supports Ghanaian musicians, but they support only the mainstream artists. They don't support the younger ones who are trying and fighting to get themselves known in the industry. But when you go, I'm a musical member. I used to go for meetings. I don't go anymore because I realized one thing that made me stop. You go there and these big names, big people in the industry, musicians, they don't come for meetings. You know what I mean? I don't want to mention names, but it don't come. You see these younger ones who are hungry and trying to make names for themselves come for meetings. And then when shows come, I mean, shows come and they're sitting on their lap and they switch these shows and the money to the mainstream artists who would not come for meetings. So how can one a guy from Obuasi or from Domayingo who's very talented and wanting, I mean, fight dying hard to be known in the industry, be known? It's impossible because you're not giving, creating a platform for him to shine or for her to shine. So that's what's really killing our industry. Always the same old faces, same old people you see day in, day out. When show comes, you see the same old people. You don't see new artists on the show. Ghana, we get about two new artists. Like 10 years, we get about 4 or 5 new artists in our industry. But Nigeria is not like that. Every day, there's a new artist coming up. They pave way for new people to shine. That's how you grow an industry.
I have a dream that one day. Yeah. I have a dream that one day.
Out AJ in 2017, I'm doing a lot. You're seeing a lot collaborations, a lot of singles are coming out, and I'm still doing my foundation thing. I'm working on an album as well. It's called Africa Rise. The album talks about what's going on in Africa, the state we are in as a continent, as a country, as Ghana. So it's going to be very political. Driven or political oriented, because you know how I do. I'm not your usual rapper who come there and just put words together and because they rhyme. No, from word to word, my music, every word means something, and every word is something that you can live your life by positively. That's what I'm about. So 2017, I'm doing really good as a musician. I'm in a studio right now, and I have about maybe 4 or 5 more songs to go, and the album will be ready. But we are not releasing the album not anytime soon, but we are going to get singles from the album before we bring the album out. Me, I love to work with talent. When I say talent, it does not matter your status in the industry. If I believe in your talent and I see that me and you have something, we have something we share in common, I'll put you on my album. You're going to hear Wiala on the album. I'm trying to get Wallasi on the album, get Akan on the album, get Mensa or maybe Kubolo on the album, and work with Kaboom. I've worked with Kaboom already. I work with my younger dude who's on fire right now, Amrado. I work with Amrado. He's dope, man. I listened to the dude last week. I was like, wow. He raps like he's been here for about 10 years. He knows what he's about. So, and I'll get Sinaso. And AI, I need you on my album, man. I need you. Honestly speaking, I'm using this platform to tell you that I need you, man. I've been calling your management. Pick my call, dude, come to the studio, let's do this, let's make history together. I believe in your talent. You know I'm still clever, better, take the way I put the west together, shining like a freaking weather, mold over your mind like cheddar, you can't mess with me, get a boy wonder, I flow dangerously. Enemy, I'm going up now, enemy, I'm going up now, they try to bring me down, they want me down, they try to bring me down. You know how I do it, you always stay positive, keep grinding, keep believing in yourself, and always be mindful that doing great is to be misunderstood. Whatever it is you're doing, which is great, the people see it, and they're going to misunderstand you from the beginning. But don't let that discourage you, keep going, keep running, do no drugs, keep close. I mean, if you're learning, make sure you learn well and you stay close to God. And man, sky is not even the limit, because you know the astronauts, they shoot beyond the sky.